हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ अशोक बगड़ा फ्रॉम डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस। वेलकम यू इन द लेक्चर्स ऑफ डायनेमिक्स ऑफ मशीनरी एंड आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज गायरोस्कोपिक इफेक्ट ऑन अ नेवल शिप ड्यूरिंग पिचिंग। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पिचिंग। ओके, we know that the front end, if we see this is the direction of viewing, this is the direction of viewing, then the front end of the ship is known as a bow and the rear end is known as a aft or stern. The right hand side of the ship is known as a port end, port side, and this is a star port, and this is our rotor. Okay, so let us see first of all what is pitching, then we will see four cases for the rotation of rotor and pitching upward and downward motion. So first of all let us derive first of all what is a pitching. So pitching, we can say that pitching of ship is the cyclic up and down motion of bow and stern in a vertical plane about transverse axis. So here we have drawn a front view of ship. So this is ship, this is bow and this is a stern. So this is a longitudinal axis, this will be a longitudinal axis, this is our transverse axis. Okay, so here we see that the ship, the motion of bow is upward and downward about this transverse axis. Okay, so pitching means cyclic up and down motion of bow or a stern in a vertical plane about transverse axis. Now in the figure we can see that the maximum angular displacement of ship is phi. So here the pitching of ship will be occur because of the cyclic motion. Okay, we can consider the pitching of ship having a cyclic motion. So we can derive an equation of magnitude of reactive gyroscopic couple. So here let us consider theta. So theta is a angular displacement of ship about this transverse axis at any instant of time. Okay, so we can say that according to the equation of simple harmonic motion, theta is equal to maximum angular displacement into sine omega 0 into t. So here phi is a maximum swing of ship about the horizontal or longitudinal axis. Omega 0 is an angular velocity of simple harmonic motion. Okay, and t is a, we consider Tp is a time period of simple harmonic motion. So we can say that our ship will be oscillate about the transverse axis. That means a ship having some angular, here the rotor is rotating with omega angular speed, and ship is also rotate through a phi, maximum phi angle. That means ship will having also some angular of precession. So this transverse axis will become the precessional axis, because our ship is rotated in about this axis. So omega p is a precessional angular velocity of precession. We can say that it is angular velocity of precession. Angular velocity of precession. Okay. Now we can say that omega p, we can say that omega p is nothing but it is a d theta by dt. It is d theta by dt. So we can say that here d by dt and theta is equal to phi into sine omega 0 into p. Okay, so we can, if we derive this, then we get phi into cos omega 0 into t and omega 0. So finally phi into omega 0 cos omega 0 t. So this is the angular precessional velocity of a ship. We know that the maximum precessional velocity is omega p max is equal to, here the cos omega 0 t is equal to 1. So we can say that maximum velocity is phi into omega 0. So we can say that maximum gyroscopic couple is equal to I into omega p max. This is the equation of maximum gyroscopic couple. Now similarly, we can derive an equation for a angular acceleration of precession. So here we again write d omega p by dt. Then we get minus phi omega 0 square sine omega t. So similar way, we get maximum angularization of precession is equal to minus phi 0 into omega, phi into omega 0 square. Okay, now let us see a first case. So let us consider the front end or a fore end of the sieve. Let us consider this is a fore end. And this is the direction of viewing, direction of viewing. So we are see the sieve from this end. Let us consider first case when rotor rotates in anticlockwise direction. When rotor rotates in anticlockwise direction with angular velocity of omega. So here we consider rotor rotates in anticlockwise direction having angular velocity is omega. And ship pitches upward direction. That means ship is pitching in this direction. Ship is pitching in this way. Okay. So now we know that this is longitudinal axis. This is a longitudinal axis. And here this is a transverse axis. So here transverse axis become the precessional axis. So again, as we know that according to the right hand screw rule, this is the angular velocity of rotor and the direction of thumb will represent the spin vector. So this will become our spin vector. Okay, and this is the precessional axis. So here we draw a precessional axis. Precession axis, or the axis of precession, or we can say that precessional vector. Now we know that our ship will move in upward direction. So we can say that this is the angular velocity of precession. This is the angular velocity because our ship is moving in upward direction. So bow will move in upward direction. So that means the angular velocity of precession will be in this direction. Okay, now we know that we have to rotate our spin vector through a 90 degree in the direction of rotation, in the direction of pitching of the ship. So our shape will pitch in this direction, that's why we rotate this spin vector through a 90 degree in this direction. Okay, so if we rotate the spin vector through a 90 degree in this direction, then this will be our active gyroscopic couple. And we know that this will be our active gyroscopic couple, and this is the angular velocity, direction of active gyroscopic couple. Okay, we know that according to the Newton's law of motion, this will be our reactive gyroscopic couple, and we know that this will be our reactive gyroscopic couple, so this is the angular velocity. Now if we transverse this angular velocity on the ship, then we can say that this is the direction of angular velocity. So here I am seeing transferring this. So this is the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. So if we see the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple, then we can say that ship, okay, now imagine that by applying reactive gyroscopic couple in this direction, then what happened? The starboard ship turned towards the starboard. Okay, ship turns toward the starboard. So we can say that what will be the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple? So we can say that the effect of this reactive gyroscopic couple is turn the ship towards the starboard. So when rotor rotates in anticlockwise direction and ship pitches upward, then we can say that our ship will turn, ship turn towards the starboard. So our ship will turn in this way. Okay, now let us see a second case. When rotor rotates in anticlockwise direction, so this clearly mentioned here, the rotor is rotating with omega angular speed, rotated in anticlockwise direction. We know that this will be a transverse axis, and our ship will move upward and downward direction about this transverse axis. Okay, and ship pitches in downward, that means our ship will move, the bow end of ship will move in downward direction. Okay, so our bow of ship will pitch in downward direction. So this is the axis of rotation of rotor, and we know that this is the direction of viewing, First of all, we draw the spin vector. So this is a spin vector. So this is our spin vector. Here, the direction of precessional vector is in this direction. So our ship will move in this direction. We know that ship will move in downward direction. Okay, so this is our precessional axis. Okay, and ship is moving in downward direction. That's why this is the sense of rotation of, we can say that this is the angular velocity of precession in this direction. Okay, now our this is the direction of angular velocity of precession. So that's why we have to turn the spin vector through a 90 degree in this direction, in this direction. That's why if we turn so that means this is our active gyroscopic couple, and if we give the sense, then we can say that this is the sense of active gyroscopic couple. According to the Newton's law, this will be our reactive gyroscopic couple. And this is the sense of angular precessional angular velocity. Now, so this is the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. Now, if we transfer this reactive gyroscopic couple on a sieve, so this is the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. So we can clearly see that this is bow end, this is a stern, this is a port end, and this is a starboard. So it will clearly mention here that this is the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. So we can say that when a rotor rotates in anticlockwise direction and ship pitches downward, then ship turn towards the port end. So this is the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. Okay, so ship will turn towards the port end. So ship will turn in this way because of this reactive gyroscopic couple. Okay, now let us see a third case. So when rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches a upward motion. So again, rotor rotates in clockwise direction, that means we assign the direction of rotation of rotor with angular velocity omega. We know that this end is known as a bow end or a fore end. This end is known as a rear end or a stern. This is our port end, port side, and this is a starboard. Rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches in upward. Ship pitches in upward direction. So we know that this is the axis of precession, and here the axis of precession is a transverse axis. Okay, so if we assume this is the direction of viewing, okay, if we plot a spin vector according to the right hand screw rule, this will be our spin vector. Okay, you know that this is our spin vector because our rotor is rotating in clockwise direction, and direction of thumb will represent the direction of spin vector. So this is a direction of spin vector. Okay, and this is a precessional axis. So we know that the precessional axis is always right angle to the axis of spin or axis of a spin vector. So this is a precessional vector. Precessional vector. Okay, and if we see that the ship pitches upward, that means ship pitches upward direction, that means this is the sense of rotation. Okay, so ship pitches in upward direction, so this is the angular velocity of precession, omega p. Now our ship pitches in upward direction, that's why we have to rotate the spin vector in this direction, in the direction of axis of precession. So we have to rotate our spin vector in this direction. Then if we rotate our spin vector through 90 degree, then this will become our active gyroscopic couple, and this will be our active gyroscopic couple, and that's why this is the active gyroscopic couple. Okay, and this will be our reactive gyroscopic couple. The vector of reactive gyroscopic couple, and if we see that this is the sense of reactive gyroscopic couple. So this is our reactive gyroscopic couple. Okay, now if we transfer this reactive gyroscopic couple on the sieve, then we can clearly see that this is a transform. We have transferred the reactive gyroscopic couple here. Then it is clearly see that when rotor rotates in clockwise direction and sieve pitches upward direction, then sieve turn towards the port end. So this is the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple when rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches upward, then ship will turn towards the port end. Ship will turn towards the port end. Now let us see a fourth case. When rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches in downward motion. We know that this is bow end or fore end. This is starboard, this is stern or a rear end. This is a port side and this is a starboard side. And the rotor is rotating. Now we can say that this is the axis of rotor. So here we draw the axis of spin. Okay, now we know that our rotor is rotating in clockwise direction with omega angular speed. Okay, so if we draw, and we know that we again always consider this is the direction of viewing. Direction of viewing. Okay. Again, according to the right-hand screw rule, we can draw a spin vector. So this is our spin vector. Here our ship pitches in downward. So ship pitches in downward direction. And we know that this is a transverse axis. And in pitching, a transverse axis will become a axis of precession. So this is our precessional axis. And this is our precessional axis, and ship will move in downward direction. That's why ship will move in downward direction. So this is the angular velocity of precession. Okay. And here a spin vector. We know that we have to rotate the spin vector through a 90 degree in the direction of axis of precession, in the angular velocity of precession. So the spin vector, we rotate the spin vector in this direction. So this is our active gyroscopic couple. That means it is a vector of active gyroscopic couple. And if we assign the direction, then this is the direction of active gyroscopic couple. And we know that according to the Newton's law, this will be our reactive gyroscopic couple. This will be our reactive gyroscopic couple, and according to the right hand screw rule, we can assign the sense. So this is the sense of reactive gyroscopic couple. Now if we transverse this effect of reactive gyroscopic couple on the ship, then this is the reactive effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. And this effect will clearly see that when rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches downward motion in downward direction, then our ship turns towards the starboard. Okay, so we have see a four cases. First case, when rotor rotates in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so we have seen four cases. In first case, rotor rotates in anti-clockwise direction and ship pitches upward. Similarly, we have see the second case when rotor rotates in anti-clockwise direction and ship pitches downward. Third case is when rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches upward. And fourth case, when rotor rotates in clockwise direction and ship pitches in a downward motion. Now let us see rolling action. Rolling of ship. We know that rolling means, suppose if we consider a ship, then rolling always occur along the, suppose if we consider this is a longitudinal axis of ship, this will be a transverse axis of ship. If we draw a front view, so this is our bow end, this is a rear end or a stern, this is bow or fore end, Okay, and here we consider, suppose this is our rotor. Okay, now rolling of ship will always, rolling means ship will turn in the, suppose this is our ship, then we can say that, let us consider another. So suppose this is our ship, then rolling means our ship will move in this way. So starboard and port end will having cyclic up and down motion about the longitudinal axis. So in the case of rolling, the axis of spin and axis of precession will be coincide. So that's why there is a no effect will be occur on the ship. We know that in a rolling, the axis, this is the axis of spin. Okay, so axis of spin and axis of precession, both are longitudinal axis. Okay, so on the same axis, spin will be happen and precession will be happens. That's why there is a no effect of gyroscopic couple. So in the rolling of the ship, the gyroscopic, there is no gyroscopic effect. There is a no okay so I hope now your concept is clear about the pitching and rolling of ship. Okay, thank you.